This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. A de facto standard is a custom, convention, product, or system that has achieved a dominant position by public acceptance or market forces, such as early entrance to the market. De facto is a Latin phrase that means in fact, literally by or from fact, in the sense of in practice but not necessarily ordained by law, or in practice or actuality, but not officially established. As opposed to de jure, the term de facto standard is used in contrast with obligatory standards, also known as de jure standards, or to express the dominant voluntary standard. When there is more than one standard available for the same use in social sciences, a voluntary standard that is also a de facto standard is a typical solution to a coordination problem. The choice of a de facto standard tends to be stable in situations in which all parties can realize mutual gains, but only by making mutually consistent decisions. In contrast, an enforced de jure standard is a solution to the prisoner's problem. Contents 1. Examples 2. Standards battles 3. See also 4. References. Examples: a selection of well-known and illustrative examples of de facto and de jure standards are, with consolidation by tradition of use, the driver's seat side in a given country starts as a user, industry preference, turning to a local tradition, then a traffic code local norm. The QWERTY system was one of several options for the layout of letters on typewriter and later keyboard keys. It was developed to prevent adjacent keys from jamming on early and later mechanical typewriters, often attributed to the typist's speed. It became a de facto standard because it was used on the most commercially successful early typewriters. The ASCII text character set, standardized in 1963, is still in use. Document files containing ASCII usually have the TXT extension. The MP3 audio format started as an alternative to CD wave lossless format for internet music distribution, then replaced it. 1995 present-day PDF computer file format was first created in 1993 by Adobe. Adobe internal standards were part of its software quality systems, but they were neither published nor coordinated by a standards body, with the Acrobat Reader program available for free, and continued support of the format. PDF eventually became the de facto standard for printable documents in 2005. PDF.A became a de jure standard as ISO 19005-1-2005. In 2008, Adobe's PDF 17 became ISO 32000-1-2008. Examples of longtime de facto but never de jure standards for computer file formats: AutoCAD DXF, a de facto ASCII format for import and export of CAD drawings and fragments in the 1980s and 1990s. In the 2000s, XML-based standards emerged as de facto standards. Microsoft Word Doc over all other old PC word processors, one of the best-known de facto standards due to the market dominance of Word. It is supported by all Office applications that intend to compete with it, typically by reverse engineering the undocumented file format. Microsoft has repeatedly internally changed the file specification between versions of Word to suit their own needs, while continuing to reuse the same file extension identifier for different versions. Other examples: most American-made spark plugs require a 13/16-inch socket to remove or install. The 1/2-inch 127. Blu-ray disc over HD DVD. See high-definition optical disc format. War examples of standards that are in dispute for turns de facto: OASIS's Open Document Format, a de facto standard for Unix users; Apache OpenOffice, LibreOffice, Calligra, Coffice et al. Use it as default file format versus Microsoft's Office Open XML format, a de facto standard for MS Windows users; Adobe Flash versus Scalable Vector Graphics SVG for vector graphics web page animations. See also dominant design free market format. War monopoly real versus nominal value. References: Carrot A. B. Ullman Margolit, Edna 1977. The Emergence of Norms. Oxford, Clarendon Press. ISBN 2015.